Hello and good morning, everybody. Welcome to our webinar, FENCOL Controller and More. My name is Thorsten Reibel. I'm here together with Torben Rösel, the product manager who will help me in answering your questions. Good. FENCOL Controller and More. What is behind? It's a topic, Clima Eco, our HVAC solution in KNX. So the old and now new, really new topic, old. Because we have shown already our solution on the Light + Building Fair in March. We were talking about Clima Eco already a bit in the last webinar, or one of the last webinars. But now it's getting really, let me say, up to date because we are launching now the first products in July. So time to inform you a bit more about the details of the first products. And this is my target today and what kind of products we are talking about, FENCOL controller and more. What is more? First of all, the main part will be our new FENCOL controllers. But to other components, I will introduce a bit the so-called room control units you see here in the middle and new KNX sensors at the moment called Clima Eco sensors. You see it here on the right. There's also a big range of products behind. So these three products I will explain today a bit. Let's have a look to the total range of Clima Eco sensors or Clima Eco components, and not only sensors. You might remember we have on the field side, on the room side, still a lot of components necessary, and this is will be our part today: the Clima Eco sensor and room control units, as the user elements, user operation elements. And the FENCOL controller, not only actuator, is also a controller, but it's still the room level. And in addition, of course, you might remember we have these central HVAC automation components, heating, cooling, circuit controller, boiler, chiller interface, and building automation controller. And on top, the application controller, not the topic today, will be content of the next webinars. And you see the products will come right now, the first products in July and until October this year. We would like to launch all our products in total over 30 new devices. A bit more technical view to the whole Clima Eco solution. So consumption park, the room part here on the right side with the three products we are talking about today. And again here, the distribution part with the heating cooling circuit controller, the generation part with the boiler chiller interface and management part with our application controller, and in the middle optional these so-called building automation controller. Again, all these things in later in further webinars. So now let's really start with a FENCOL controller. FENCOL controller FCCS. So what will be available, and the availability will be next week. So then the products will be on stock for the FENCOL controller. A FENCOL in principle is not a complicated device. We would like to control with our FENCOL controller. It's a component for heating and/or cooling in the room, very often used worldwide. In principle, it's a heat exchanger behind. In this example, we see a four-pipe system with two pipes for the cooling part and two pipes for the heating part. It can be only a two-pipe system only for cooling or heating. What we are controlling is the valve. Different kind of valve that can be controlled, but there's not only heat exchanger, there's also a fan, a blower behind to blow out of this component the cold or warm air. And the speed of the fan we have to control as well. So these are the two main parts to be controlled. At our FENCOL controller, we can connect different, other, let me say, signals. We can connect binary and analog values. You will see what for what purpose. Binary contacts, for example, a window contact. Analog signals could be an floor temperature sensor which is connected. And our room control units, a further component I would like to show today, can be also directly linked to our FENCOL controller. What are the main features of our new components? So FENCOL control is nothing new for us. We have already many years these FENCOL actuators, but it's different a bit. You will see it's now called FENCOL controller. What we will have is the most comprehensive product family for controlling all kind of FENCOL units in the KNX market. In total, we are talking about nine new devices. What can be done with this component? First of all, let's concentrate on the valve drive control. We can control electrothermal valve drives, as before, and also motor valve drives. Motor valve drives need two contacts, open-closing of the valve. For this purpose, we have two electronic outputs in the devices available. So you can control either two electrothermal valve drives or one motor valve drive with these two outputs. A further typical valve on the market is controlled via 0 to 20 volt signal. It will be also available in our new components. If you use these devices, then you will have two of these 0 to 10 volt outputs available. For example, for a four pipe system with two valves for heating and cooling, this can be controlled completely with one fan coil controller. If you have a motor valve drive, as mentioned, you need then two outputs. To the two electronic outputs we have, then only one output or one channel will be available. Control of the fan, typically done via one, two, or three steps, as before. But new is now that we can control also so-called 0 to 10 volt operated fans. So we have a continuous fan speed control now available, which has some advantages, and I will explain this a bit later. So it's really new. But the trend to 0 to 10 volt or continuously controlled fans is existing on the market. So in more and more projects and more countries, we find these fan coil units. And then, of course, we need also the right way to control this. Now possible. And out of these, let me say, binary or digital or stepwise control and analog control of fan and also the valves, we can have now any combination. I give you later an overview, resulting in 8 new devices without and with manual operation, but all possible combinations of these fan and valve control is now possible in our components. Yeah, so it gives you new options in covering the requirements regarding fan and valve control on the market. A further new topic is that I mentioned already, we have it now called fan coil controller. Not fan coil actuator anymore, because in all these fan coil controller, a temperature controller is integrated. So it's in principle not necessary anymore to have a room temperature controller, because the controller is inside. What we need, of course, is the actual room temperature of the room, and we have to send a set point to this device, and then the complete temperature control for a fan coil unit will be carried out by such a component. So that's really new. It gives us new options to reduce, let me say, the effort in the room control units on the operating elements, because no controller really necessary anymore. And we have the right products to do this, a special combination. And you will see later the real combination out of this. In the ETS, you can still say, okay, I need only actuator functionality as before, or I need the controller. So it's selectable in the ETS application. Yeah, as mentioned, we have components with and without manual operation. You see here two examples. So the classical way, you press a button here to activate the manual operation in the middle, and then you have the chance to change the fan speed or to open and close the valve. And we have also an additional relay inside these devices, and this can be operated as well. So classical way of manual operation. Yeah, beside the outputs I have mentioned already, we have also 4 inputs available. These inputs can be programmed either as binary inputs to connect any contact, a window contact, a normal push button can be connected, a dew point sensor, or it can be programmed as analog input, and then it's prepared to connect any temperature sensors of different types. You see here PT100, PT1000, KTY, NTC, and NI1000 style, let me say, temperature sensor can be connected. And also, later you will see it, our room control unit RCU. So in the software, you select between binary functionality or analog functionality. Each of these 4 inputs can be parameterized accordingly. A further new feature is the possible control of 6-way valves. A six-wheel valve is in principle a valve to control a four-pipe system with heating and cooling with only one 0 to 10 volt control output. So you need only one output. You have no, let me say, problems anymore that both heating and cooling is running at the same time because it's controlled, also mechanically separated. And this is a special situation in some projects, and we are now prepared for this. So in case of this solution, you can take our new fan coil controller. I mentioned already that we have two 0 to 10 volt valve outputs available if you choose a component with 0 to 10 volt. Maybe you need only one 0 to 10 volt because you have a two-pipe system, or you have this control of six-way valves. Then the second 0 to 10 volt output could be used to control ventilation flaps, dampers. So air handling or air control can be done with this. If you select here these variable air volume controls, you have some dedicated parameters. And a further option here to control these kind of components. Yeah, as with all our new components, we are have access to the IBAS tool. Means these components are also supported by ABB IBAS tool. I show you later some screenshots of this integration. It's in principle for testing some functions, for operating some functions, for looking at some status information. You can simulate different situations just for maintenance or for commissioning. Makes life much easier, as you know, hopefully, from many other components which are supported by the ABB IBAS tool from ABB. Yeah, the keypad I mentioned already for manual operation. And the additional relay can be connected here on the upper right side. We had already before in our fan coil actuators. For example, you can use it for operation of an electrical heater together with a fan inside, of course. So it's a situation we see sometimes. In principle, a freely programmable switch output additionally here available. I mentioned nine components we will have. One device will be a bit reduced component in terms of hardware of outputs. No manual operation, no additional relay inside, but it's also lower in costs. So it's a kind of a budget variant. This might be interesting for some projects. I give you later an overview, or let me see a picture also of the connection diagram and also component itself, what is behind. So in total, nine new devices. Our existing fan coil actuator FCAS will be replaced because we cover in principle everything what we do with the existing fan coil actuators, with some more functions. And so it makes no sense to have so many other older devices. So within the next half a year or until beginning of next year, it's planned to replace the existing components, FCAS. So if you still need for any projects, these components still available, but keep in mind that it will end approximately end of this year. Yeah, let's have a look to some mainly new features in the ETS. It's a KNX device, of course. We need the ETS. It's programmable with ETS4 or ETS5. I mentioned already here the six-way valve control, so 1 0 to 10 volt output for heating and cooling. We can control ventilation flaps, and if you select this for channel B, for example, here for channel valve B, you can choose between different way of controls. Not only 0 to 10 volt, but also 1 to 10 volt, 2 to 10 volt, or 10 to 0 volt also. So inversion of this value in principle. A new feature, also a request from you, from the customers, from the market, to have a temperature limitation available. Remember, our inputs we have can be used for temperature inputs, for analog inputs. So, for example, you could connect here a temperature sensor measuring the temperature in the floor, which might be interesting for a floor heating system in order to limit the floor temperature to avoid any damage of the floor or to have uncomfortable hot floor, which is not very nice to walk over. So then we connect here the temperature sensor and we program a temperature limit this will be not exceeded in case of temperature control of your room. So it's a very often demand to do this, and now possible here directly in the component, and you can connect directly also here the sensor. Then we have here an extended way of start up and run on behavior. Start up means for the fan, you switch on your FENCO unit and the fan shall run for a defined time on a certain level. For example, you say, okay, I would like to have at the beginning a boost mode with speed 3 for 10 minutes, for example. This can be adjusted here. And the run on behavior means if there's a request to go down with a level of the fan from 3 to 2, for example, then it will stay another certain time in this level. Yeah? And then only it will go to the lower level, which is required according to the control value. It's now possible to have these run-on behavior with individual times for each level. Yeah? So if you switch off, for example, your FENCO unit, and you can say, okay, in each level, it has to stay another 3 minutes. So it will go to speed three after, to speed two after 3 minutes, then another 3 minutes maybe to speed one, and further 5 minutes goes off only, yeah? Just to have a controlled, let me say, switch off behavior in your FENCO unit. There are some more features inside, more software features. So, but here the main new features we have here in the ETS application. Keep in mind, for all 9 devices, we have the same, the same software functionality. So there is no difference. Of course, if you have the component without the relay output, you cannot parameterize anything here, the additional relay output, but all the main features or functions are the same for all components. Yeah, let's have an overview of all the components. These 8 devices you see here, in principle, it distinguishes between the way of control of the fan and the valve. And as mentioned, all combinations are possible. For example, if you take the first one, 3-step fan, and you can control electrothermal valve drives or motor valve drives. If you go to the version 1.3.2.1, it's with manual operation, fan 0 to 10 volt and valve 0 to 10 volt. Or the next one here, 1.5.1.1, has fan 0 to 10 volt, but electronic outputs for the valve to control electrothermal valve drives or motor valve drives. Yeah, so together with the option to have with or without manual operation, we have in total 8 different devices here available. And where is component number 9? It's the so-called budget variant, where you have only one electronic output. See it here on the upper left side. We have 3-step fan control and no additional relay available, but also these 4 inputs, either analog or binary. So it's a bit reduced device, but also lowering costs. That's the advantage here. Yeah, let's have a look to the connection diagrams of all these devices, just to understand what can be or how it can be connected. You see always on the lower left side, the inputs, analog digital. On the upper left side, you see here 2 electronic outputs, in this case to connect 2 electrothermal valve drives. And on the right, the fan connection and also the additional relay available. Same component can be used to control 1 motor valve drive, because we need 2 outputs to have these up and the open close functionality. But the same hardware in principle. So then I can have a 0 to 10 volt output for the valve, gives me 2 outputs. Again here, 3-step fan control. Or have everything with 0 to 10 volt, both for the valves and also for the fan. Here again, see 2 electronic outputs with electrothermal valve drives, but analog fan speed control, so continuous control of the fan speed. Or you use it the same device for motor valve drive control. And again, analog fan speed control. Yeah, and the small version of the budget version, a bit reduced, only 1 electrothermal valve drive can be connected. three-step fan speed control, no additional relay, but again here our inputs for binary or analog values. This is another summary of all the functions, so hardware functions we have in principle here, of all the components. I don't want to go into details, but you see here some have these motor or pulse width modulation control, some have these 0 to 10 volt control. Six-way valve control can be only done with devices 0 to 10 volt valve output, because we need this analog signal to do this. And we distinguish between three-stage fan and continuous control, depending on the type. The rest is more or less the same. Of course, we have some without and some with keypad available in our components, as always. So again, a summary with some more also commercial data here. First of all, the components are really available next week. So all 9 devices, then they will be on stock. And you can order them, no problem. So here the components, the first 4 ones, then the next one, and finally here, this budget variant, and again, all in the next week available. I mentioned already, we will replace the existing FENCOIL actuators FCAAs, and you see the products here on the lower right side. We had, or we still have, 4 different components, in principle with and without manual operation, and the difference between the devices was mainly 0 to 10 volt valve control or electronic outputs for motor or electrothermal valve. That was the only difference here in principle, plus manual and no manual operation. But of course, there are some software differences, and I would like to emphasize the differences between these two components. The FCCS, of course, has some more features, this integrated controller, especially to connect, you will see it later, these simple and very cost-efficient room control units. So you need no external controller anymore. We can control these continuous fan with 0 to 10 volt. We can connect variable air volume flaps, also controlled via 0 to 10 volt. And we have all these combinations available we hadn't here with these FCAS. But the FCAS has still also differences compared with the FCCS. The FCAS has 4 electronic outputs. So in principle, you could control 4 electrothermal valve drives or 2 motor valve drives. And with the FCCS, you can control only 1 motor valve drive. That's the difference you have to accept. And we have 2 other differences here. The relay output for the fan in the FCAS was also able to be programmed as standard independent relay outputs for controlling any load. This was, from our point of view, hardly in use. If you use a FENCOIL actuator, you use it for fan speed control as well. So this was not really in use practically. And there was an additional time function available, or is still available, in the additional relay, the staircase time we don't have anymore. So these are the main differences here. But again, keep in mind that anytime these FCAS are not available anymore. So, I mentioned already many times this continuous fan speed control. Behind this application, you hear sometimes the so-called EC motors, electronic commutating motors. So these are motors to be controlled via 0 to 10 volt. And of course, it has some advantages why we do this, or the market requires such a solution. So again, we have here now no stepwise control anymore, but continuous control, resulting, of course, in a more comfortable way of temperature or fan control. It's more precise. You have less wear in these components. So these motors are very, let me say, long-lasting devices. And less, let me say, losses, so it's much more energy efficient. And that's also the reason why it's more and more used and required in projects. So both is still on the market, stepwise control and now more and more continuous control. But we are prepared now to also run these kind of Fancall units on the market. That's a big advantage, and I'm pretty sure that you will come more and more in contact with these electronic commutating motors with this continuous control of the fan speed. And you remember we have four devices covering this application without and with manual operation. So we are prepared for this right now. Yeah, let's come now to connecting this to the real operating element in the room. We have the FCCS possible edge controller. And now I'll show you already these so-called room control units, SAF/A. I come to some more details later. These are non-KNX devices and very simple devices just to change the set point with this rotating knob here. And then on the upper right side, you see here a button which allows you to adjust the fan speed manually. Or you say, I would like to switch off everything. Or you go to normally to automatic mode, means depending on the control value, the right fan speed will be enabled. And this component, as it's a non-KNX device, will be directly connected to the inputs, to the analog inputs we have in each of these fan coil controller. Details a bit later. Prerequisite, of course, is to do or to have a complete solution, you have to parameterize the FCCS as a controller, because this room control unit has no controller inside. It really only measures the room temperature and allows you to change the set point. This will be sent as a more or less analog value to this FCCS working as a controller, and then you have the complete room temperature control available. But of course, it's still possible to use KNX, real KNX room temperature controller. And I show you already here the so-called climate echo sensors, more details also later. So I communicate in the classical way via KNX in both directions, but then I don't need any controller functionality inside the FCCS anymore. You let's say downgrade it to a typical actuator, which is possible in the ETS application, and then you have the classical way of implementation of room temperature controller. Yeah, in principle, you can use any KNX room temperature controller, not only our new ones, but also, for example, here I show here the Tacteo room temperature controller or any other from the KNX range we have. So there you have no limits in principle. You will see later we have in this climate echo sensor range also components with only room temperature measurement or only with a display to operate as a slave. And this is also possible to be connected here as it's a KNX device that communicates via KNX. But as there is no controller inside, we need again the controller functionality inside the FCCS. The only thing we need from here is mainly the room temperature measurement, which will be available here. The benefit here is that you can reduce the effort in these elements here in the field, in the room, reduce the cost finally, but no disadvantage in operation and no disadvantage in functionality. Yeah, these different options to connect either via KNX or via these analog inputs, different kind of controller or sensors. I tried to show here. Allow me to explain. Again, we have to distinguish between simple actuator functionality in our fan coil controller or complete functionality together with a controller capability. If you use it as an actuator, you can take, as mentioned, any room temperature controller from the KNX market. Here another example, our room temperature controller from the range of commercial sensors. I have here another option, which belongs to this logic controller together with a temperature sensor connected directly to the analog input. My logic controller can have a controller inside. I need only the room temperature. I measure via the analog input together with a PT1000 sensor, for example, and then I would have also a temperature control. Would be possible. Very specific solution I show here, but just to show you what in principle is possible. If I say, okay, I use the full functionality as controller with the controller inside, I can take via KNX any temperature signal, either from our climate echo sensors, or here an example with an analog input and any other, maybe PT100 sensor. Of course, I have to sense a set point as well to this device. It can be from any push button or from a central visualization, and then already temperature control is available. Or as mentioned, I connect our room control units or directly here to this component, to the fan coil controller, also an analog signal for the room temperature, and I had also a complete solution. So you can play a bit with these options here, just to show you that we have many more options now, depending on the project, depending maybe on the optimization of a project. And this gives us new options here with these solutions. Yeah, as mentioned, we have IBAS tool, ABB IBAS tool support available here together with the fan coil controller. So you connect via the physical address as always. And then you have four parts available here. First of all, the first part status shows you only the actual status of the device depending on your programming, depending on the actual situation. For example, you see here, okay, it's programmed as a controller. The fan of the system is in automatic mode. There is a control value for heating, basic stage here visible. Maybe you have also additional stage available. So we principle cover here is a complete unified RTC concept. You might know from many other components. You see, is it in cooling or heating mode? But it's only status information here. We can go to the next one, it's controller. And what you see here is again heating or cooling stage. You can change, but also here something. You can only visualize what is existing, but you can change also the operating mode, for example. So you go to standby, you go to economy or protection, and of course also to the comfort mode, resulting in different set points, of course. And this will be shown then here on the upper right side. In my case, you don't see it, but practically you will see it. But not only see, if you want, you can override the set point. So you type in a new set point and then you simulate a new situation and can check the action done by your fan coil controller. Some more options, the controller parameters, let's say the P and I component can be changed here as well, just to check the behavior of your controller depending on changing of these values here. Plus again, some values, the heating basic stage, which percent it is right now, or the additional stage, and the different values for the different operating modes here. So that's related to the controller. But we have outputs. Remember, we have these outputs for the valve and the fan. And in addition, this relay output. Also here we see the actual status. But we can say, okay, I would like to check the behavior of the system if I increase the actuating value for my electrothermal valve at channel A connected. So we can override here as well. Yeah. And the same for the fan speed. In this case, a three-stage fan is connected, and I can activate the different speeds here directly. Output B, maybe it's for cooling in this case. The same behavior as for output A. And my output F, the relay, can be operated here as well. So typical functions and information you have here with our IBAS tool together with our various components. These are the inputs still left, of course. We have still inputs available. Remember, either binary inputs or analog inputs. Here in this case, we have parameterized for input A, the window contact. So you can simulate the window functionality by opening and closing this contact just to check the reaction of your system. And here to input B is any temperature sensor, PT1000 connected. So you see directly what is parameterized. Input D, for example, is not in use here. As mentioned, the products will be now really available next week. What does it mean? Not only hardware and software, but of course also the documentation, all the necessary files, including the application, the ETS application, specification text, and more. Has to be on our internet, on our homepage, and this is already existing. You can have a look right now. So if you go to the KNX components category, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, you can search for FCCS, and then you will get everything what I mentioned already. So we are really online now then also with this component. Okay, that's at the moment all for this fan coil controller. But you have seen there were already two other components visible. And I start with the room control units, SAR/A and SAF/A. So two devices will be available also in July. So also available right now. And let's have a look to these components. As already mentioned, these are not KNX devices. So very simple operating elements just for the set point adjustment. You do it via this turnable knob here. And if you use a version for fan coil unit control, you have an additional knob to change the fan speed, switch off the fan coil unit, or go to standard automatic mode. So these are these two devices, very simple ones. All or both devices also measure the temperature. So it's not only adjustment of set point and fan speed, but also temperature measurement integrated. Of course, you know, we need for any temperature control, of course, also the ambient temperature in the room. So very simple to use. So nobody has to learn about it. It's low in price, of course. It's not comparable with a KNX room temperature controller. Of course, there is no display available here. There is no LED. It's a passive device. So we have no power necessary. We only connect this component to the analog inputs of our fan coil controller. Yeah, and the target of this component is to have, or these components is to have a solution for project where you require such a simple operation and a low cost version for room temperature operation. Yeah. Nothing else and nothing more, but gives you some more options. And it's exactly made to be connected to the fan coil controller. And you see also in the next slides, a product which comes in August together with a valve drive controller. Same concept. So we have only these two devices, nothing different. And SAR/A stands for, R stands for radiator, means to control only a valve drive. And F stands for fan coil, means controlling also the fan speed. So integrated temperature sensor, only white color available. And it's a surface mounted device, means you have a kind of supporting frame you fix on the wall. The wires have to come in, and then you connect the wires to this upper part of this component, snap it into the frame, and then it's done. So relatively easy to install. You need no wall box to install this. And keep in mind, again, it's not a KNX device. So no KNX connection necessary, but how to connect this component? Okay. You see again the combination with the fan coil controller. No details of the connection at the moment, but will come very soon. So this we have seen already. Possible also with a valve drive controller, not a product for today, but you will see in the next webinar in September, we will talk about this device, which can be used also together with our room control units. But now we come to the real connection. How to do? Very simple. We have only four terminals, four connection terminals here at the room control units, A and B. A is reserved for the set point connection, means is linked here to this rotating knob and has to be connected to channel A, to input channel A of the fan coil controller, because this is, let me say, reserved for the set point, let me say, measurement. Yeah, and practically it's nothing else but a resistance here. We measure via the analog input, and then it will be evaluated inside the fan coil controller to do the right action. Second pair of connection is channel B here, and this is in principle the room temperature sensor integrated here. This can be connected to the other three, or one of the other three analog inputs I can program here in the fan coil controller. I have connected here directly to channel B, of course, makes it easier at the beginning. And the only thing you have to do now in the parameters of the fan coil controller, you have to adjust. Input A is used as analog RCU input, means set point input. And of course, for the next channel where you connect the temperature sensor, you program also analog input. And the type of the sensor, which can be adjusted in the fan coil controller, has to be NTC20. And of course, then you adjust here the parameters for the controller inside, and then you have the complete solution already. So how do we detect here the additional fan speed or the situation that we would like to switch off or go to automatic mode? Also behind this rotating knob, there's only a resistance. So, and this resistance will be added to the main resistance of the set point here and here. And this will be evaluated here in channel A. And the system knows, okay, if I have this kind of value, it can be only speed number one plus, of course, the resistance for the set point I have adjusted. Very simple, but efficient and works fine. Yeah, here again, a bit bigger, these two components. You see here still the Bujega sign, but it's also available then, of course, with ABB. What do you do practically? You adjust a set point, a basic set point inside the FCCS, the controller part. Then you can decide how much less or how much more I would like to allow to be adjusted. So typically you can say, okay, maybe 22 degrees is a basic set point, and I allow to reduce by -3 degrees, or -3 Kelvin, and by +3 Kelvin. Yeah, this can be adjusted, but you see not directly the set point. It's a relative adjustment here. So you would like to have a bit warmer or colder, then you turn this knob here and it works accordingly. Yeah, one version only in white. And here again, the version with also fan speed control. So available already. Ready to order. So these both devices as planned in July this year. Yeah, let's come finally to the Clima Echo sensors. The next part I would like to show you to you today. And now we are talking about real KNX components. Yeah, and not only for temperature control. In principle, we have created here a new range of push buttons, push button sensors, and room temperature controller, but it's more than room temperature control, you will see, together with our Clima Echo HVAC range. So it's an add-on, an additional, let me say, range of sensors. You will see later, we discussed already, it's not only possible to be used with Clima Echo, with HVAC, and even more, you can use any other room temperature controller also for Clima Echo or for HVAC solutions. But let's concentrate here on these new products. It's a real complete range. First of all, I start with these components here on top. In principle, 8 and 12 volt push button sensors, but these devices have also an integrated temperature sensor. All devices have of the Clima Echo sensor range have an integrated temperature sensor. And together with a controller and the FCCS, you could do the following. Okay, measurement of temperature, I send it to the FCCS, controller inside the FCCS, and I change here the set point by pressing the button, maybe two fixed set points, 20, 22. Yeah, or up and down is also possible, or the next push buttons could be different operating modes, standby and comfort. You can describe it here in this labeling field. So it's also a way of operation of a room temperature controller. Okay, you have no display to show any actual values, but in some cases it might be sufficient, possible. Then we have so-called control elements with RTC slave, 6 and 10 fold components like this here. So with a display, with a temperature sensor inside, but no controller inside. Why? Remember, we have it already in our fan coil controller. We don't need it really here. So if you want, you use the RTC slave together with FCCS and you have the full functionality. The customer does not see any difference compared with classical room temperature controller. But if you want, you get also complete room temperature controller integrated, the same look and feel like here with a display and the 10 and 6 push buttons. It's also available, number 3 here. And even more is available. The fourth level is again these components, but with also integrated CO2 and humidity measurement, relative humidity, but not only measurement, also control functionality is possible. So these devices allow to control room temperature, air quality, CO2, and also humidity in the room. Of course, you need the right actuators. Remember, our fan coil controller is made for fan coil, means for temperature control mainly, but we have also fan behind. Or you use the 0 to 10 output for a damper, an air damper, to get more fresh air into the room. Finally, to have a better CO2 level. Yeah. And further actuators can be used to reduce or whatever increase the humidity in the room. Yeah. So it's real room climate control then. Possible with these components here. Yeah, as mentioned, we have in the middle this labeling field. You might remember from other KNX sensors we have in our range, there's a web tool available to create some labels which can consist of any text or any icons, just to describe what's behind these push buttons. All devices, yeah, first of all devices have not a separate bus coupler anymore, so it's a single block device with integrated bus coupler connected on the frame typically. So to avoid any removal of this device, we can have here so-called anti-theft protection. It's a special clamp, and so you cannot remove it anymore. To be able to remove it, you need then a special further tool. It's the same concept we have as our glass sensors Tacteo. A good solution and the same concept here. It will be a worldwide product. What does it mean? It can be installed in different markets with different standards, VDE standard, British standard, NEMA standard, Australian brackets. So we are prepared for this. And yeah, that's the fact in these devices. But if you are not happy with any of these, let me say, options, we have a further option to install these components also surface mounted with a special additional mounting box or support frame box, so-called. So then you need no wall box anymore, but only the KNX bus cable coming out of the wall. You mount the basic frame first of all, and then you snap on this component directly here, resulting in a bit more depth, installation depth compared with the flush mounted installation in the wall box, but it's a further option here. So you're really independent of any standard in the world. I'll show you later these mounting frame you can buy as well here. Yeah, we support this unified RTC concept here, as with many other devices. Also, this component only available in white. Yeah, so at the moment only in white. We will see what happens in the future, but the white is the color at the moment. Studio White can be programmed with ETS4 and ETS5. Also, very nice is a display here. For those who have seen this already on the Light and Building Fair in March, it's very relatively big characters or digits here in white as well, so well illuminated. So it's a good user-friendly solution, let's say. We have status LED at each rocker, following the day and night mode concept, means you can reduce or switch off the LED during the night. And also this multicolor concept we have in ABB, so not only red and green, but also some other colors for the LEDs are available depending on the function behind. Yeah, the so-called ABB color concept. No frame necessary. What you can do is the upper and the lower stripes can be removed. The lower stripes, for example, necessary to remove for getting access to the programming button. Yeah, and if you have to insert here the labeling field, then you can also remove the upper stripe here and insert then your paper, your labeling field. This is also here possible. Yeah, availability. The first two devices are available right now, or more or less next week. Here it's a bit different at the moment. No exact date we can say right now. Still something to do, but we will inform you as soon as possible when will be the component available. But at the moment, no fixed date possible right now. Yeah, connection to our fan coil controller. You see, I can use our FCS as an actuator here again, and then It takes the components from climate echo sensors with RTC integrated, with room temperature controller integrated, or any other one. Example here again, the Tacteo. So this is a classical version. You can say, okay, I have controller functionality, then I take only the climate echo sensor with integrated room temperature sensor, which would work already, or the slave version, RTC slave, to see directly what I'm changing here. So we use a KNX communication in both ways to implement the complete solution. The further option I've mentioned already that we will have in the next webinar, the valve drive controller, same concept. You can use it also together with this component because you can reduce it also to an actuator. Then you use a room temperature controller again. And the valve drive controller together with controller functionality and with these climate echo sensors with room temperature only or with a slave, RTC slave function. But this will be then a topic for the next webinar we will have in September. But the same concept in principle. So also pure valve drive control will be available with integrated controller functionality. So a small preview already to the next webinar. But I think you are still interested in some more details of these climate echo sensors. So here I've also some bigger images to see how it looks like. I start with a RTC slave version in six rockers. You see here the display. And these icons, you can really operate everything. You can change the set point plus minus. You can switch it off completely. The FENCOL unit behind. You can change to echo mode, means a different set point and fan speed control plus change between heating and cooling. Possible. So I send only the commands to the FCCS with the controller inside, and everything will be done inside the FCCS. The same available with more rockers, tenfold, but the same functionality in principle. You see here on the end of the text, KNX participant 2. What does it mean? All climate X sensors with display has to be counted as two devices in terms of current consumptions. So normally we say maximum 12 milliampere per KNX device. Here we have maximum 24 milliampere because we need some more current for the display and also for the LEDs. So it has to be counted as two devices. Benefit is here that you need no additional power supply for these components. Yeah, some other components need for RTC version or for display version an additional 24 volt, for example, not necessary here, but it has to be counted as two devices. The version with room temperature controller inside looks the same in principle, but with integrated room temperature controller with six rockers or with 10 rockers. Yeah, and then we have the highest level with more functionality inside. The 6-volt with integrated humidity and CO2 measurement and controller. And you see already in the display, not only room temperature or the set point. Maybe this is the room temperature, I think, yes, and the set point. But also here in this example, you see the CO2 concentration as a real value inside your room. And again, the same concept for the 10-volt version. Yeah, and last but not least, the simple standard push button sensors, 8-volt. Remember, always with integrated temperature sensor, 8-volt, and finally the 12-volt version. Yeah, the accessories I would like to explain a bit. Remember, we can use also or create also surface mounted installation. What does it mean? We need these additional support frame, so-called, very simple. What you have to do, the KNX cable is coming out here as a wall. You use some screws to tighten it on the wall. And then you click only your component onto this frame, and then you have the complete solution already. So we need different frames depending on the size of the components. We have a small version here and the large version. This is for the push buttons. And yeah, of course, also for the room temperature controller or the RTC slave. So for this, the two different sizes we need this. further feature we have, standard version of our climate echo sensors, is that the labeling field has a transparent cover, means it's possible to insert any piece of paper with your icons, your text, and then you can see what's behind the functions of the rockers. So it's a bit like the Solo system, let's say, the Solo range. If you want, you can replace this transparent cover by a white cover, the same style and color of the rockers. So then you have an even, yeah, smooth white surface without any labeling field, of course, anymore. To do this, you can buy separate, yeah, covers for the labeling area in white as the color of these rockers here. And there we have also different versions available. You see here also for the simple push buttons, you get it. To do this, you remove only the lower stripe here, and then you can remove also transparent cover, the standard version, and insert here the white cover. No problem to do this, very simple. Yeah, last slide. In principle, we have shown not all, but some of these room-oriented devices or field devices, our climate echo sensors, our room control units, and the first step we will deliver now, the fan coil controller. Of course, it's only part of our complete climate echo range and concept, but all the other components here, not for today, the topic, but will come in the next webinars. So I have a look to the chat. Yeah, Tom, you got a lot of questions again. You could all answer them, yes? Okay, thank you. So I don't go into any details. At the moment, what we are always doing, as mentioned already at the beginning, we will summarize all your questions in our FAQ. So anybody then will have access to this. We will structure it a bit, of course. And so thank you for your numerous questions. And we are really seeing you are interested in, and you are thinking about the solution already. And good. We will still keep this chat a bit open after we have finished the webinar, so it's possible still to send us further questions if necessary. Let's have a look to the next webinar. Next webinars, we will have two. We will announce right now. In August, of course, it's holiday months. We do not have any webinar, but we continue on the 12th of September with further new climate echo devices coming now in August and also September. It will be this already mentioned valve drive controller, VCS, the heating cooling circuit controller, and boiler chiller interface. Real new functions, real new components, with some more options now to control HVAC solutions together with KNX from ABB. As always, two sessions on the 12th of September. But as we have more new components coming very soon, we have added an additional webinar 1 week later on the 19th of September. And then Jürgen will come on the stage again with the topic metering. And you might remember from last year, this Ecomatic topic, where we launched already a concept together with Emboss meters, with the energy analyzer to collect all the data, will be extended now by a Modbus version. And also the firmware of this energy analyzer will be updated a bit with further options to collect and process data here. So an additional webinar 1 week later, but to all these webinars, of course, we will invite you on time. Thank you for your participation, and see you next time. Bye-bye, ciao.